you hold me in your arms? Cause I need you. How I need you. I need your love like I need water. Created
to let it all go. Yeah, I see it now. I'm laying it down, and I know that I need you. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I'll run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, oh, oh. You saw my condition, had a plan from the start. Your son for redemption, the price for my heart. And I don't have a context for that kind of love. I don't understand, I can't comprehend. All I know is I need you. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, oh, again and again and again and again. Oh, 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 oh. My heart is beating, you're
Good morning, everybody. I'm Father Mike Miller. I'm one of the priests here, and we're all praying and handing over the soul of our sister Connie into God's hands. Probably some of you are Catholics and some aren't. I just want to tell you about two things about Catholic funerals, and then we'll start. Catholics, of all the different parts of the Christian church, Catholics are the most ritualistic. And if you're into it, there's something so comforting about doing those things. If you're not into it, they look very strange and odd. Anyway, when there's a funeral, it's a ritualized last visit of a person to her church, the last visit of Connie to St. Margaret Mary Church. And just like when Catholics come in the door, they bless themselves with the holy water to remember they're baptized, and then they take their place. On Connie's last visit to St. Margaret Mary, she'll be splashed with the holy water, the baptism water, and then we'll walk right down here and take our place. I'll tell you a few other things during the ceremony, but welcome. I'm glad you're here for the family. Will you please stand and face the back door of the church? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God, the Creator, did not make human beings for death and darkness. God made us to live, and God made us for life. And God sent Jesus Christ into this world to break the power that death had over us. I bless the ashes of Connie with holy water that recalls the day of her baptism. Connie, Concepcion, on the day of your baptism, you were joined to Jesus Christ, and you stayed joined to Jesus in death. Take three steps forward. Connie, to show his love for you, made of flesh, to make a pilgrimage through this part of life, may Jesus Christ now embrace you and cover you with resurrection. Let us pray. Oh God, be merciful to your that Jesus Christ left to and all just to which we all go to life in heaven with you through Christ. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, faith teaches that your Son died, but then rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Connie, who's fallen asleep in Jesus Christ, may rejoice now to rise with him and through him. Because Jesus Christ lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We'll sit down and listen to God's word, and Carlos Hernandez will share the first reading.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a season, a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to root up what is planted, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to embrace, a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek, a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to discard, a time to tear, and a time to sow, a time to keep silence, and a time to speak. God has made everything suitable for its time. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is
nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. The Lord
is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil shall I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these, you give me comfort. The Lord is my shepherd.
There is nothing I shall want.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you've anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. The Lord is my shepherd,
there is nothing I shall want. Now Desiree will share our reading from the New Testament.
A reading from the Book of Revelation. I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away. The sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He would dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Peace to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I am the bread of life that comes down from heaven, says the Lord. If anyone should eat of this bread, he shall live forever. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After the resurrection, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb. Jesus approached her, though she didn't recognize him for Jesus. He said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought he was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him, in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me. I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and yours, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I've seen him, the Lord," and what he had told her. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced. When they saw the Lord, Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father sends me, I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. And Alex and Desiree are going to share some memories, and then I'll have something to say about the scriptures.
I picked a verse from the book of John. It says, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe in also me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me. You also may be where I am." I decided to pick this verse because Connie, as you all know, was very involved in the church, and she was my godmother. And I believe that God has prepared a very special place for her, and he will take care of her. And although she is not with us, she is in a better place and is no longer suffering. And just as God has made a space for her, eventually one day we will all be able to be with her in the house of God. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
First of all, I would like to praise and thank God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit for having breathed the breath of life into one Connie Barrera Shotkoski. She was the love of my life. God brought the two flesh and made them one. She brought the best out in me. She made me a man. She helped me to fulfill all my responsibilities as a husband. And I love her for it, and I miss her. She completed me. I'd like to thank the Blessed Virgin Mary for helping me to weather this storm. I'd like to thank my son, Eric. This has been a bumpy ride, and it's not over yet. I'd like to thank Father Mike. I'd like to thank the St. Margaret Mary's Parish staff, Jorge, Kim, Gilbert, for all that they've done and made me feel like family. And I'd also like to thank my brother and sister-in-law, Henry and Henrietta Hernandez. They've been a tremendous help to me, and I'd like to thank Lisa and Carlos Hernandez because they handled the internet stuff for me. I'd like to thank Desiree and Jatania Loyal. They've been very helpful in helping me. Anna Velasquez for all the meals she's prepared for us. And I'd like to thank Larry Tomlinson, Antonio Roscoe for all the help that they gave me. I needed somebody to talk to and they were there. Most of all, I thank all of you for coming this morning and honoring my wife, Connie. She greatly appreciates it, and from the bottom of my heart and the bottom of her heart, we love all of you, and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Alex. Family said she was caring, generous, never afraid to lend somebody money, loved cooking for the priests. They said, strangely, she was noisy and quiet. Sometimes people can be noisy and quiet. I'm not sure how that works, but we're a mystery, and sometimes there's a quietness about noisy people, and there's a noisiness about quiet people. Manager of the senior center, the site manager, liked sewing, made cabbage patch dolls, 40 years married, had a side of her that was mischievous and an instigator. She was happy and at times a little crazy. She liked the outside. She loved perpetual adoration. And right before she went to the hospital, I mean, it's one of the saddest stories connected with this coronavirus thing we're all dealing with. They were in line to go to confession. And then it was a long line, and it just seemed like it could be put off. And I'm sure God knew it was in her heart and took it as another act of holiness that she did. About those readings, Mary Magdalene, that's after the Easter, but before Jesus had ascended to the Father, wanted to hold on to him the way I suspect many of you would like to hold on to her. But we heard for the first reading, sometimes there's a time for holding, there's a time for everything, and sometimes there's a time to hold on to people, and sometimes there's a time to let go of people. And because you're not God and I'm not God, God tells us what time it is now. If God sends up the sun, it's day. No matter if you say it's night or I say it's night, If God says one thing, I guess that's the way it is. And God has said, this is our time for letting her go. The other part of that story, you know, after we're only halfway through Lent, I think halfway on this very day. The beginning of Lent, Catholics take the ashes on, and we all tell ourselves mostly and tell each other, we have a date. The date is with God. The date is for the bridegroom to come down when it's our time and take us off to the bridal chamber and then to the feast of heaven. And jumping ahead to what comes at the end of Lent, it's always Easter, and it's always Jesus coming out of the tomb with a big smile, and it's always Jesus breathing life back in. It says he went into that closed room where the people were scared and breathed on them. I don't much like to have people breathe on me, to be honest. I don't even like to breathe on myself. That's one of the worst things about this, is you just kind of are stuck with your own breath, and sometimes it's really not the most pleasant thing in the world. But the breath of Jesus, that's the Holy Spirit, it must be a lovely breath. It must be a perfumed, sweet breath, kind of that you would like to smell and just keep smelling. He comes to the apostles in the closed room, just like he might come to ashes in a closed box, or come to people in a closed church, and walks over with a smile and lays a hand on our shoulder and breathes. Like as in artificial respiration, breathes, because we had lost our breath. Breathes because the coronavirus attacked our lungs and we couldn't take another breath. Breathes, and with his breath, restores life. And not just puts us back the way we were, older and wiser, but puts us in heaven, younger and built to live forever. This is a sad moment for you folks. It's not a sad moment for her. So the best that you can, be happy for her, even though you're sad for you and you're sad for them and ought to be. However, just the Bible also says, don't grieve like those who have no hope. There's no need for that. We can cry out of one of your eyes, but never out of both of them. Because if one eye looks on the world and is sad, the other eye ought to be fixed on Jesus. And when your eye, even half of one eye, is fixed on Jesus, everything somehow is okay. And you'll get through it. And on the other side, there's a season God has waiting for you too. Able to, even behind the mask, take a deep breath. Sometimes people that need courage, taking a breath helps, and God has breath to give people. And now let's stand, and Eric is going to share, lead us in the prayers of the faithful, and we'll say, if you can join in the prayer, Lord, hear our prayer, after each of the prayers he offers.
For Connie, who in baptism was given a place of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our sister Connie, that they may be concealed in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, as sons and daughters of God, may they offer their suffering to him with patience and trust, and know that the compassion of love of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may have gathered together in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers that we hold in silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, our confidence in you and in what you want to do for our sister is so strong that even with her ashes close by, we put bread and wine on the altar and declare that you are good and that we trust you and believe in you. Hear our prayer and call our sister to your side and make our faith in you stronger through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Connie, we beseech your mercy. May she find now in Jesus Christ her loving Savior, because Jesus Christ lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed but not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples. He said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Alberto, our Bishop, and Gerald, the retired Bishop, and the clergy. Remember your servant, Concepcion, born December 8th, Connie, whom you have called from this world to yourself. She was united to Jesus Christ. Grant her forgiveness of sins and a resurrection like the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Remember all our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection. Bring them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
We all like to have our own way. Depending on how stubborn you are, you like your own way, or you really, really, really have to have your own way. But in the Our Father, we give God the bow of our head and tell God that he should have his way and his will. So let's say that prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. We forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. To Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from distress as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accord with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, happy are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Time for Holy Communion, and you're all invited to communion. If there's some reason you don't want to go, you're not a Catholic, or you just shouldn't be going right now, you can stay at your place for this part, or you can come up and go like that, and that'll be a sign for the minister to bless you.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey we all must make, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Connie may come now to the eternal feast of Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Sit down, please, just for a second. After the service, we're all going over, well, those that are able, over to Pomona for the burial. But the last thing that takes place in a Catholic funeral in church is called the rite of commendation. And I don't know how many of you have been with someone when they died. And what I'm going to describe doesn't always happen, and it doesn't even happen half the time, but it often happens. And it happened, in fact, right in front of my very eyes a bunch of times, but including when my dad passed. My dad was had been in a coma, and for 3 days he was at home with hospice, and his face was, he had had strokes during the coma, and his face was all kind of like that, not very, real ugly. And we were standing around the bed where he was laid out, and as we did a bunch of times, and prayed, we said about three words of that prayer, and his face straightened out, just like that. Well, that was startling. And then his eyes opened. Oh, that was very startling. And then he starts looking around at all of us. I have three sisters, and I was there, and my goddaughter, and my mom. He was looking for my mother, of course, and he sees her, then they kind of go like that, and then he looks up at something that's up there that no one else saw, and smiled, and right then and there died in front of us. And that it doesn't happen all the time, but it actually often happens that people go through what they call the quickening. The quickening is like a person all of a sudden becomes more alert than usual and appears to see something that no one else is seeing. And the early Christian, this is not something that we made up in the 1900s or 2000s. This is people have noticed this since there was Christianity. What they took from it was the early Christians, as a person got ready to die, the people that had been watching over them from the other side came down to accompany them and take them home. Jesus, the Virgin Mary, her guardian angel, her parents maybe. Anyway, the rite of commendation is that we're going to do now is we'll have you, Alex, hold your wife's ashes, and the rest of the family stand around. And on behalf of the church, I'll call on Jesus and Mary and the holy ones to come from heaven and bring her home. So will you go have her ashes and stand right here, if you don't mind. And family members, come and stand around. Stand right here is good. Thank you. Saints of God, come now. Come to meet her angels of the Lord. Jesus Christ, Alpha and Omega, resurrection for all of us sinners, come. Mary, Mother of Jesus and Mother of the Church, come. Holy ones who've watched over our sister from the other side, come, gather around her and bring her to her home. Connie, may God, who called you, take you now to himself. May your companions be angels and saints and holy ones. May you refine your day, this day, your peace, and enter into the new and everlasting Jerusalem. Now take your hand and put the cross on her. And may Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you.